Good evening, class. In the last lecture, we have already discussed about the equation and inequation. On the basis of equation and inequation, we also deal about some questions. Today we will discuss some more important questions which is not based on the graph. Means that except graph, how we solve a question? If there is a question like this, write down a question. The question is that x e to the power sin x minus cos x, and this is equal to 0. Suppose we take the interval 0 to pi by 2. Then in this interval, how many solutions it have? There is a problem here. Since the graph of this function is very complicated, or it may be in some questions, there may be some graphs which cannot be drawn so easily. So in such cases, we use some other technique for solving such type of questions. Okay. So here we use the technique of differentiation. With the help of differentiation, since we know that if the derivative of any function is greater than 0 in the particular interval, it means that in that interval the function is increasing. Okay. If the value of derivative in that interval is less than 0, it means that function is decreasing. So by using the property of increasing and decreasing function, we deal this. Okay. So, look at here, the solution of this. Suppose our function is f x, and this f x is x e to the power sin x minus cos x. There is no problem. Okay. So, since at the value 0, it gives the value minus 1. There is no problem. When we put the value pi by 2, it gives the value e pi e by 2, and this is 0 in this case. So we get two value. First at the 0, we get value minus 1. Second at the point pi by 2, we get the value pi e by 2. Means that if we look at this plane, so at the point 0, its value is minus 1 somewhere. So the graph is starting from there. Now, graph is going in the upward direction. At the point pi by 2, it reaches at the point pi e by 2. So, pi e by 2 is somewhat here, okay, situated here. So, the graph reaches at this point. It means that if graph is starting from there and going to at this point, in this situation, the graph crosses the x axis. At the point means that the x coordinate where this graph crosses the x axis, that is called the root for this. So, it is clear from this observation, if at the point 0 it gives the value minus 1, and if at the point pi by 2 it gives the value pi e by 2, it means that it must have at least one root between 0 to pi by 2. Okay. Now, for another root, how we know? For another root, we differentiate the given function. Okay. So, after differentiating, we get x cos x e to the power sin x and plus e to the power sin x and plus sin x. Okay. And our interval is 0 to pi by 2. Look at here. In this interval, x is positive. The graph of cos x in this interval is also positive. E to the power sin x is positive. E to the power sin x is also positive. And sin x is also positive in this interval. By drawing the graph, one can see, suppose this is the point pi by 2. So, if this is a graph of sin, then this is the sin graph. And if it is a graph of cos, then the graph is like this. So, sin, cos both are positive in this interval. There is no problem. So, all these values positive implies that f dash x is greater than 0, and this implies that f is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing means once the graph crosses the x axis, it never comes again at the x axis. Okay, means that it does not produces the another root. Means that it has exactly one root in that. So, The number of solution for this is 1, and that lies between 0 to pi by 2. There is no problem. Now, we discuss for a polynomial. Suppose we write here a polynomial of degree 7. Okay. Suppose we write down here the polynomial x to the power 7 plus 14x to the power 5. Okay. This is the polynomial whose coefficients are a real number, and suppose here 16x cube. Okay. In this situation, all the coefficients are a real number, okay, and plus 30x minus 560, this is equal to 0. Suppose we assume this polynomial, or we represent this polynomial by the function fx, okay. So, look at here. There is a very important result in mathematics. If there is a polynomial whose order is odd, must possess at least one real root, clear? So, it must possess at least one real root, and the nature of that real root or the sign of that real root will be the opposite sign of the last term. So, about the root and about the sign of root, we can clearly pre-assign or we can clearly predict. Okay? So, we predict about the root, it must contain at least one real root, since degree of polynomial, since degree of polynomial is odd, hence it possesses at least one real root. Okay. Now, after that real root, if it possesses one real root, it means that at some point on the coordinate axis, the graph touches. Okay. So, if we find the derivative of this, means that our aim is to find what is the nature of graph. So, when we find f dash x, then the f dash x is equal to 7x to the power 6 plus 14 into 5x to the power 4 plus 16 into 3x square and plus 30. Okay. Look at here, this term is positive due to the even power, this term is also positive, this term is also positive, 30 is already positive. So, total term is positive, means that this term is greater than 0. When it is greater than 0, implies that our function f is strictly increasing. If our function is strictly increasing, it means that after crossing the x-axis once, it never comes across the x-axis again. Okay. So, it means that it has one root, and that root is due to the degree of polynomial. Okay. After that, it does not contain any root. So, the answer is only one root. There is no problem. Now, on the basis of this, we discuss about quadratic equation and quadratic expression and equation. First of all, after doing quadratic expression and equation, we know about the polynomial. What is a polynomial? A beautiful equation of this form. Suppose we write down f x equals a n x to the power n plus a n minus 1 x to the power n minus 1 plus a n minus 2 x to the power n minus 2 and dot dot so on plus a naught, where a n, a n minus 1, a n minus 2 and dot dot so on, a naughts all are a real number. Okay. So, this is a polynomial, and we say that the highest power coefficient is a leading coefficient. Okay. So, here a n is a leading coefficient and this is called constant term of a polynomial. Constant term of a polynomial. If we observe that this polynomial is nothing but this is a function, if we cut some part of this polynomial, suppose we take only a naught, then it is also a function, then it is also a polynomial whose degree is 0. Once again, if we cut this polynomial from there, then this is also again a polynomial, means that every part of this polynomial is also a polynomial and this is also a function. So, here we discuss about the polynomial and polynomial equation. Now, what is the polynomial equation? Our next is polynomial equation. If we put the polynomial equal to 0, suppose we denote the polynomial by px or fx and this is equal to 0, then this represents the polynomial equation. Okay? Now, what is about the root of polynomial equation? Our next term is that root of polynomial equation. Okay? Let us suppose that fx equals an x to the power n plus dot dot a naught, this is a polynomial equation. Okay? So, about the root of polynomial equation, we say that a real number alpha is a root of this polynomial. We say alpha is root of fx if f of alpha vanishes, means that it gives the value 0. In that case, we say that alpha is a root of fx. Okay? Now, our next aim is to find what is the position. What is the position of root? If a polynomial equation is given, then where root lies? So, our next aim is that position of roots of a polynomial. Let us consider a polynomial. Position of root of a polynomial. Let us suppose that we take a polynomial fn, fx, and this is equal to an x to the power n plus an minus 1 x to the power n minus 1 plus dot dot so on and a naught. Okay? an minus 1, a naught, all are the real number. If we take an different from 0, means that we take leading coefficient different from 0, then we say that this polynomial is of degree n. Okay, now, about the position, let us consider that a and b are two real numbers. If a and b are two real numbers such that f of a into f of b is less than 0, it means that the function at the point a have some sign, then at the point b it has opposite sign of that sign. Okay? So, if first have positive sign, second have negative sign. If second have positive sign, then first have negative sign. In such a situation, what will happen? If this situation occur, in this case graph crosses from lower to upper or upper to lower, means that in this case the graph crosses the x axis. At the point of coordinate axis where the graph crosses, that will give the root of this polynomial. Okay, so this will be the exact location of that polynomial. So, in this situation, if this holds, implies that fx have at least one real root, at least one real root, this term is very important, at least one real root, means that always possess a solution, one real root between this interval a to b. If it possesses more than one, then in that situation always it possesses odd number of roots, means that either it have one real root or always it have odd number of real root. Okay? So, if this situation occur, then our polynomial either have one real root or always in a odd number of real roots. Now, the next situation is that suppose f of a and f of b is greater than 0. In that situation, if this situation occur for two real number, in that case either this polynomial have no 0 between a and b, or if it has 0, then always even number of 0. So, if this situation occur, implies that fx has no zero or no root, zero is the synonyms of root, no root or even number of root. Okay. So, this is the something about the position of a root. Now, what will be the deduction with the help of this? So, we deduct some important result with the help of root of a polynomial. The first result and the most important result is that if an equation is of odd order, means that let us consider an equation result 1. If an equation is of odd degree, is of odd degree, means that every equation of odd degree always possesses at least one real root, is of odd degree, then it must possess at least one real root, at least one real root. And about the sign of real root, and the sign of this real root will be opposite to the last term of the equation. Means that if last term of the equation have positive sign, then it root will be, it root have the sign negative. If the last term is negative, then it root have positive sign. Okay, so it possesses at least one real root whose sign is opposite to the last term of the equation, last term of the equation. And all these things is valid only in those case when we take the leading coefficient greater than 0, provided leading coefficient is positive. So, it is very important, means that if any equation is given whose order is odd number, so in that situation we directly can say that it must have at least one real root, and that real root have the sign opposite to the last term of the equation. Okay, and the next thing is that leading coefficient must be positive. So, directly if an equation is given whose order is odd, we can directly say that it must possess equation. Similarly, we can say for second result, suppose that equation is of even degree. Suppose we take a equation of even degree. So, our second result is that every equation of even degree whose last term is negative, okay, means that if a equation is given whose last term is negative and the degree of that equation is even, has at least two real root, has at least two real root, one of them is positive and other is negative, provided that the leading coefficient is positive, okay. So, this is also very important result. Now, our next result is that if in a equation plus and minus changes only one time, means that like that equation, suppose we write down a equation x to the power 4 plus 4x cube minus 16x and plus 14, this equal to 0. Here plus and minus changes only one place, at the only one place. So, if for any equation there is only one time changement of sign, negative to positive or positive to negative, in such a situation it must possess a root. Okay. So, in this situation it also possesses a root. Now, our next situation is that suppose there is a equation, okay, and all the coefficient of that equation is positive, and there is no term in that equation in which the power of odd term occur. Means that suppose that our third result is that if all coefficients of an equation is positive and there is a no term involving in that which is of odd degree, means that odd degree term does not occur in this equation. In such a situation, all the root of that equation are complex root. So, if all coefficient of an equation is positive and odd degree term not occur, then all the roots are complex root. Okay. So, this is about the position of roots and some deduction on the basis of the roots. Now, we know the sign convention method of Descartes about the polynomial root. So, our next topic is that for sign convention. Okay. According to the Descartes, if a equation is given, okay, and positive negative terms are alternatively comes occur, means that if one time a positive coefficient occurs, after that negative, after that positive, maybe two positive consecutive occurs. Okay, in such a situation, according to the Descartes, suppose f(x) is a polynomial. Suppose we take f(x) as a polynomial, okay, then it have maximum positive real root, means that it has at most positive real root is equal to the number of time positive changes into the negative, or conversely negative changes into the positive. Means that suppose we take a equation x to the power 4 minus 5x to the power 3 plus 6x square plus 7, this equal to 0. In this equation, one time negative changes to positive, okay. So, there is only one changement, negative to positive. So, it must have at most one real root, positive real root, okay. So, this equation must have one positive real root. Similarly, for negative real root, one can discuss, means that suppose a equation have, suppose we have take a polynomial, the same polynomial if we take f(x) equal to 0, then it have at most n negative real root, okay, it have exactly n negative real root if the coefficients of f of minus x changes as many times, means that suppose it changes two times, minus to plus or plus to minus. So, it has exactly two negative real root. More precisely, one can say that at most two real root. Okay. So, this is the situation. So, how many times it changes? Suppose we take this example. So, first of all, we find f of minus x. So, x to the power 4 plus 5x cube plus 6x square and plus 7. So, there is no changement, it means that it does not have any negative real root, okay. Since no term is changes, no coefficient is changes, either positive to negative or negative to positive. So, it does not contain any negative root, okay. So, this is something about Descartes' rule for sign convention for a root of a polynomial. So, thanks class, we will discuss in the next class on the basis of quadratic expression and equation and by using some deduction of the result, some questions. Okay, thanks class.